Always try and keep your hand or your trowel as dry as possible, because what you end up doing is creating blisters and calluses. So just keep wetting, drying your hand all the time.
Is that 150 to go?
Again, not too much water.
Okay, so you want to bend that right hand pipe a little bit. Use your knee. Come down here. So just bend it a little bit with your knee so it goes out away from the
shoulder. If you notice, I always use my left hand to grab my water brush because that's the hand that gets wet the most. And I keep my right hand dry. That's the one that's holding the trowel all the time. Again, if you're left-handed, then you just swap over.
It's just catching the joints.
Thinking about that. You've got new window boards, because they're primed MDF. What we all do from the start, we put our brushes and wet trowels, try and keep as much water off them as possible. They're already primed, ready to paint them. The excess plaster off and the wall that we're about to skim. Well, before we skim it, we've got to pull that reveal in with a bit of hardwall first of all and then put a bead on it so it might not get skimmed today.
Is that
low?
Let's go.
I don't know
about my screen. I was going to say, bloody hell, just cut with them and just blow the ceiling. Right, well, you've got that, the reveal there.
Sam?
Yeah, definitely.
Tony, the tea maker.
Tom? You the tea maker?
Aye?
You...
Hello?
Are you the tea maker?
I'm alright, mate. I think you should do it now, you're on to another gauge, actually.
Aye? What I'm going to do is bury them in, take them off. What I need to do really is treat myself to a new brush. She's getting a bit old and she's losing her hair. But if I'm honest, I'm a bit tight.
Got another one on the right side.
Hey?
Got another one there.
I need another big one like that.
No, there's another hair.
Where?
There, right hand side.
Oh, yeah. There you go. Right, what you do, because there's a little bit of things, you leave a bit of fat there like that. Yeah?
Yeah.
And what we do is leave that on there for a minute. Let that pick up a little bit, and we come back and take that off, and that fill that little hole I've just created by taking that air out. Because I'm too heavy handed and got fat fingers. That's the problem. If you had little girly fingers like Sam, you'd be alright.
Yep.
Right, Sam, you've got that sponge.
Yep.
Rinse it out, that's it. So what I use the sponge for is, when I take the hairs out of it, is for the awkward parts that my trowel can't reach. We just sponge it in slightly. We'll go over it again with the trowel. It just takes the sharpness off it. There will be pipe covers over that as well when they do fit the rad. We've been told. Been that a little bit longer on there. That's our second trowel done, second wet trowel done. I didn't want to bore you with it, so I thought I'd just crack on. Now what we're going to do now is give it a hard trowel, which we call a cross trowel. Not so much of the water flicking on the ceiling itself, but still have the brush in your hand, and it's all about wiping the edge of the trowel, keeping it nice and clean at all times. Nice clean trowel, sharp, straight through. You can use a spray bottle instead if you want, than a brush. Some people tend to do that as well. My brother-in-law used to. I don't like it. I like the old saying in my hand. Makes me feel nice and strong.
Right, as I said, this one here.
Open your trowel a little bit more, because now you're trying to get a bit of a shine on the ceiling itself. Wipe the back of the trowel. Don't flick the water on the ceiling. And as you can hear, slightly different. If you go back there, Sam, can you palm up the back of me?
Yeah.
If you have a look, that's the effect you're trying to get. Okay, we're going to give it one more on top of that as well, so you will get a more of a shine. You don't want to give it too much. If you give it too much, when you're rolling your paint will slide. And that's not what you want, okay? Let's just show you a little bit more, and then what we'll do, we'll end up cutting it for a little while, just till we get to the end, and then we'll go again afterwards. From all directions. Nice, that.
Nice and smooth.
Nice and smooth, like a baby's bum. So we're basically done now. I'm going to give it one more hard trowel over the top, just for argument's sake. And then that's us. I've just noticed, which you would have caught on camera, this dodgy cut around this socket. What should happen is this board should be flush all the way around that socket. I never cut this board. One of my colleagues, the carpenter on site, actually cut it, thinking he's doing us a favour to get the job moved on a little bit. All he's done is caused us more work. So what we're going to do to rectify the problem is we're going to use undercoat plaster, which is hardwall, in and around the edges, which will bring us flush all the way around. We're going to do that in a minute, and we do that before we plaster tomorrow, which is when we're going to plaster this window wall. And at the same time, of course, we're going to fill in all around the edges as well at the same time, and anywhere else. Just thought I'd make you aware of that, as it's on camera, so you don't think we're cutting any corners. Same with anywhere around like sockets, pipe work like this. What we do is we get nice and tight in, and that'll have another coat of undercoat plaster before we set it, and around any bits of boxing in again. We're also going to bring this in with hardwall, and then to cover the gap, because obviously it will crack, there's going to be a doorstop trim there. Door trim normally sits centre of the door, but we're going to oversway it because this was the existing part of the building, and the client didn't want a full door lining coming from end to end. They didn't want to see the edge of the woodwork here. So we've got a nice finished bead down on the edge here and a door trim, which will finish nicely. The door will shut on, it'll look nice. So I'm just gonna give it one more pass. If you have a look again, there's no real water going on the ceiling again. It's all about hard trowel, which we call it in the game. Basically, wet trowel again. Use your brush, One more.
And this is the last pass now. Nice and forceful. Got set now then.
That's set. Yeah, that's dry now, so you can touch that. If you have a little feel of that wall there, Sam, tell the clients what it's about.
Ooh, lovely.
Yeah. That's the finish what you're looking for.
Nice, smooth.
Smooth finish, not over-egged. Because if it's too smooth, as I said before, the paint will slide off it. You don't want it too smooth, but obviously you want it to be nice and shiny. Pay attention to your angles, because that's what your eye is drawn to as you first walk into a room. So nice sharp angles as they are. Nice sharp beads, always keep the bead nice and clean. They've run the nose of your trowel on the edge of the bead there. Nice sharp bead, nice and clean, ready for paint. Simple as that, really. Hope you enjoyed that on-site raw how to plaster a ceiling video. We like to keep things simple. We will be showing a few more as and when we do them. Stay tuned to Tommy's Yard. See ya.